what's good? It's your boy North Santa Fe Gorilla. We gotta get into this. So listen, bruh, we can't keep doing this to ourselves. You feel me? Like, at some point, well, let's just say this. So I wake up this morning and I'm seeing all these videos being recommended to me about, you know, J3 knows the truth. And this dude is basically saying that Fredo was never G's friend. Fredo had a secret grudge against G about a female. If you've ever listened to any of Fredo's interviews, he said, me, and I quote, me and G share females. Now, I do remember him going back saying there was one female I didn't know about, you know, him doing. But then he said that's cool because we shared females anyway. So, you know, that was my partner. I told him the first time I got burnt, we knew a lot about each other. And, you know, we as bloggers, we really got to stop doing this. Like, I ain't gonna lie to you. Some of these rappers give us answers in their songs. But, bruh, you really talking about the verse he used in Father when he said, G, you say you love me, but you went and slept with my best friend. G Money died, now I gotta sin again. If you know anything about Bang, he's only said in songs and mentioned two best friends that we really know about, G Money and Crazy Trey. So how can you say he was talking about G in that verse when he was talking about Crazy Trey and G in that song? You trying to put a lyric about him saying to a female, you say you love me, but you went and slept with my best friend. G Money died, now I gotta go sin again. You talking about a lyric. You don't even know the which best friend he talking about. You don't even know the story behind that, bruh. And yeah, of course we know young boy ain't did nothing to G. I said that in my video, like, some videos ago. I was like, so for anybody mad at Bang for doing anything with young boy, y'all gotta understand, the only thing he ever did was this, G. And, he never had nothing to do with his death. That's just like J.D. Youngkin. R.I.P. God rest his soul. But Fredo did, work with him, and Jay dissed G. So at the end of the day, yeah, you dissed somebody. We have a problem, but we don't know what's been resolved and what's been said behind closed doors. Both these dudes have dissed each other's dead partners, and yet they're coming together to be at peace. So at the end of the day, when it's all said and done, if they can come together and get peace, get money, and stay out the way of the radar of the feds, why are you bloggers mad? Y'all bloggers is mad because if they don't beef, y'all don't have nothing to talk about. Yeah, Baton Rouge is the most popping, most hot topic talked about. And when they at peace and they not beefing and doing no calamity, you don't get to make videos about who gonna die next. You don't get to make videos about your time running out. You don't get to make videos about these dudes sneak dissing each other. And now you've ran out of content. So I get it. I'd be upset too. If I didn't have multiple things to talk about, if I didn't have the talent to get people's attention only talking about Fredo and Youngboy, which I get people to watch my stuff talking about other people. So, you feel me? We gotta stop this. I hate Fredo Bang, whoop the woo, we mad at him. You know, did you know he slept with one of G's girl? Did you know that? Like, at this point, it's like you are purposely trying to destroy this man's character to make people be swayed into being mad at him for the toy drive. It's over. Like, this is the percentage right now. 60% of people are happy that toy drive happened. Okay, 60% of them are happy. 30% are like pissed off about it. And the 10% is trying to decide whether they care or not. So, y'all, let that go. Let that pain go. You know, at the end of the day, I know what this is about. G's no longer here. People are hurt about that. And guess what? It's time for us to accept that he's no longer here. And we have to move in a different path now. We can't continue the slut, shit back and forth. We got to move in a different way now. We can't bring him back. So, at the end of the day, what has been said about G? What's been said about G by his family? It's been said that he was a loving person. He showed love to everybody. And that he wasn't out here stepping in the field. So, you mean to tell me that living in the name of G means to step in the field when that was something he wasn't even doing? Now we're choosing not to step in the field, and now we're choosing to enjoy life, the things that he did, which is by means living in the name of G. I don't know what the problem is, why people so upset, but let it go. You gotta let it go. You're gonna let that eat you up, and you're gonna lose hair, you're gonna grow wrinkles, and you're just gonna be pissed off. Like, this dude really made 7 to 10 videos on things about Fredo. And so what? If Fredo felt some type of way about a female in the past, if there's some female in the past and you didn't just get that from the lyric on Father. As I said, and as he said, they shared girls. So what's the big deal? And at the end of the day, if it was truly one of those problems where a dude talking behind a dude's back, G and Fredo would have fell out, bruh. And I don't care how big his heart is, because if he was going to fell out with Young Boy about things being said, then he was going to fall out with G. And Young Boy used to stay with that man. He looked at, so you could say that G and, you could say Fredo and Young Boy was somewhat in the same lines of friendship with this dude. Because he both looked at them as a brother. And he never came at Bang like that. So, yeah, I don't know, man. It's your boy, No Son of Fake Gorilla. And I'm out. Salute.